Being a photographer for many years and with my position here at Adorama, I see a lot of equipment. Every year manufacturers are coming out with new stuff and it's really cool to have all the new technology, but it's not that often that something comes around where I'm like, wow, if this really lives up to its hype, this is gonna change the way I work. When Profoto showed me the B2, I had to really put it to the test. So even though this is gonna be a great device for event photographers, I'm a fashion photographer and a location portrait photographer. It's the middle of the winter here in New York City. This is a battery-powered pack. I said, let's take this thing out in the field and see how it performs. I took a small crew up into the Hudson Valley and we drove around in my Jeep, found some beautiful locations and really put this thing through its paces. Hey, this is Daniel from Adorama. I'm here with the new Profoto B2 and I'm really excited to show it to you. So like the B1, the B2 is a TTL flash. And like the B1, it can use all of Profoto's accessories. Profoto's left the front of it the same diameter, so you can use all your accessories you already have if you're a Profoto user. What's different from the B1 is this is a pack and head system. So you've got your tiny little head here and then a power pack that an assistant can wear over their shoulder or you can hang on a light stand. It's 250 watt seconds, which is plenty for most usage. And it's great when you're working inside because it dials down really low. A lot of times people look at the maximum watt seconds of a unit and they think, well, I need a lot of power. But if you're working inside, especially with these new cameras, you actually need power that can go down. And a lot of people are finding that they can't get their flashes low enough to fill in and make it look natural. A lot of clients want natural light looking shots, but they also, you need to be able to get the shots. So this Profoto head, being able to dial the power way down, working really quick with TTL, it's gonna be a great tool for an event photographer or anybody who needs to go out on location. Okay, so let me walk you through the features of the Profoto B2 pack. To turn the pack on, you just hold this down, and you can see here I have two different heads plugged in, and this is my power level. So the first thing is I can set up my sync. Right now it's not set on anything. I would plug a sync cord into it if I want to work like this. I can go into the air sync, and then I can also go into slave, which would just fire it off of another flash. So if I go into air sync, I can go set, and I can set my channel here, and then I hit it again, and you see I have A and B. I can set both my heads to whichever zone I want. So if you have a bunch of flash units, you can basically mix them together. I can also put them both on the same if I want them to go up and down the same on my controller. So once I have that set, I can hit it again. The third thing, this is my modeling light timer. So I can set how long I want my modeling light to stay on. And if you go all the ways up to dash dash, it'll just stay on until you turn it off. So once you're set there, you've got a few different options here. I can turn the individual heads' model lights on and off here and here. I can set my mode to either normal or freeze. Freeze is gonna give you a much shorter flash duration, but the color temperature is a little bit cooler there, so just be wary of that. So in a situation where there's not a lot of ambient light and you really wanna really stop action, you can set it in freeze mode and you'll get a shorter flash duration. Right here for ready, you can either set it to dim the modeling light or nothing, or you can have it beep when it's ready. So, or you can have it do all three. So on the side of the pack here, you've got your spot for a sync cord if you want to plug in directly. There's also a place here in this case for the thing to vent so you don't overheat. And then you can actually charge it while you're operating right here. To put a fresh battery on, you simply lock it on here, like that. Okay, so here's the air controller. So you can see here that I have my channels in B and C. So if I go here to the B channel on my controller, I can actually adjust my energy up in tenths of a stop. You can see it changing on the pack. Or I can hold it down for a second, it'll go up one stop at a time. So I can lock that in like that. Also from the air controller, I can switch from manual to TTL. If I'm in TTL and the pack picks the proper exposure, I can then switch back to manual and it will actually keep the exposure where it was. So that's kind of a cool feature. Also on the controller here, I can switch my sync, my channel, and it will tell me which sync I'm in, whether I'm in high speed sync, first curtain, or second curtain sync. So this is the Profoto OCF barn door. It clips right on the front of your head, and it's a four leaf barn door. This is the OCF snoot. This will clip right on the front of your B2 and give you a nice circle of light. This is the new grid set. I have three grids here. To swap it out, you just push it out like that. Put a new one in, and you're good to go. This is the new OCF speed ring. It's got this feature where you slide your rod in at an angle and you just click it in, making it much easier to build. Also, you'll notice all the colors on here, depending on which box you're using, you put the rods marked with those colors in there. So Profoto created four new softboxes for the system that are lighter weight softboxes. There's a 1-foot by 3-foot strip, a 2-foot octagon, a 2-foot by 3-foot softbox, and a 1.3 by 1.3 foot softbox. All of these have honeycomb grids available. So I'm gonna say this product not only lived up to my expectations, but exceeded them. I was actually surprised by the amount of power we had. We used a lot of high speed sync, sometimes up to 8 thousandths of a second. I was able to use the different softboxes and modifiers to blend the light with the natural light. When I'm working on location like this, I don't like to just slam the model with light and make it look like they're standing in light outside. I like to make it look natural. So using the TTL and the Air TTL controller, I was able to really blend the light in. When we were underneath a gazebo, I was able to throw in enough light that matched the outside without it looking like it was lit. When we stood in the woods and it was all kinds of patchy light, I used a smaller softbox with the grid just to give a little bit of light on the face so it looks very natural. We stood out near the river and I was able to use the flash to fill in and match the ambient light so you could see the bridge in the background and also get a nice blue rich sky. Because it was freezing cold out and we had to work quickly, a lot of the times we had to assemble the gear sitting in the truck. So you can imagine using larger units how hard that would be. It was simple to sit in the front seat of the truck and assemble a softbox while my assistant was in the back setting up the pack or the camera. Also, the B2 worked really well in the studio. Because the pack can take two heads, I was able to do nice lighting scenarios, giving a hair light and a fill light. I also used the high speed sync because I have a daylight studio to match the light in here and make it look really natural. And we also set up the two B2s on stands and a B1 and mixed it all together using some of the new OCF modifiers and made some really nice portraits. So I think the B2 kit's gonna be a great tool for event photographers, wedding photographers, portrait photographers, and also editorial photographers and fashion photographers like me. The ability to go on location with a very small kit, be able to control your light with enough power without having to stack 4 or 5 speed lights together or carry on a generator to use an actual pack, really, really changes it for me. I'm super happy that Profoto let me test it, and I'm definitely gonna add it to my kit. I'd like to thank Profoto for letting us borrow the B2s. It performed exceptionally. This is Daniel Norton for Adorama. I'll see you next time.